Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, great question sent in by Mary Lou. Mary Lou wants to enter dates, but she just wants to enter the month and year. So, for example, for July 2008, she would enter 07/08. However, when she does that, Excel thinks that she's entering the month and the day, so it automatically translates to July 8th. She said, this is driving me crazy. How can I fix this? Well, my initial reaction was we're going to create an event handler. So, I'm going to switch over to VBA, Alt F11, and double click on the sheet to see the code. Left drop down, choose worksheet, and then the right drop down, choose change. And we can write a little bit of code here that'll grab what she types and reformat it the correct way. However, I wrote some code for her and it didn't work at all. And it ended up what happens is even though she types, for example, 5 characters, 07/08, immediately before this event handler runs, Excel is converting it to a full date. So, for example, if I would do message box target dot value ampersand VBCR to go to a new line, ampersand LEN of target dot value. All right, let's just try this. I'll come back here and I'll enter 07/08. What we'll see is that even though I typed 07/08, Microsoft thinks that I typed 7/8/2008 and the length is really 8. So, when we start to write this code, we need to think about the fact that basically, as soon as I type 07/08, it's going to put a date in there. And so, what I came up with is a little bit different code than where I thought I was going to go. Basically, I assume that we're going to be entering the dates in column D. So, if the target.column is equal to 4, then we use the isDate function. If what they just entered is a date, we launch into this bit of code where we say the month, that's a variable name, is equal to, we use the month function, and then the year is equal to the day function. So, I typed 07/08, Microsoft thinks that the 08 is the day, and so I asked for the day of that. Now, of course, it's going to convert it just to an 8, so I have to add 2000 to it to get it up to 2008. I turn off the event handler and write a formula back into the cell that uses the date function. Basically, I concatenate the year variable, the month variable, and the number 1, and then convert that to values. So, let's give it a try. We'll come here and over in column D, I'll enter a date, so 07/08, and you saw it flash there briefly, but now when I go back to the cell, I have 7/1/2008. Sometimes Microsoft just has these default actions that it uses that will really drive us crazy, but luckily, with a tiny bit of VBA, maybe 10 lines of code there, we're able to convert that to handle those situations and bring it around. This one was a little bit more complicated because I assumed when I typed in 5 characters, I would see the 5 characters in the variable called target. But instead, even before this macro runs, it had already converted it to the wrong date. Still able to solve the problem. So, thanks to Mary Lou for sending in the question, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.